In this video, you are going to learn how to send countless messages on LinkedIn, but not by doing it yourself, but by using a robot. We're going to create a Microsoft Power Automate desktop robot that is going to create countless messages on LinkedIn and help us save countless hours of time. Now, if this sounds interesting, it is interesting, and also it is not illegal. It is not illegal because this is legal. However, it can get your account banned on LinkedIn if you don't take certain steps that I will show you in this video. Without further ado, let's jump right into this and see how we can create a LinkedIn automated robot that is going to do some lead generation for us. As always, we are going to start from a blank canvas. We're going to create a new flow and we're going to call our flow LinkedIn bot. Remember to name your bots with something meaningful so you don't lose track of all of the different automations that we're going to create together. And just as a reminder, this is a series that I'm creating to remake all of the bots that I have lost in the latest update. So what are we going to be automating? We are going to create a robot that is going to do a search on LinkedIn for us. It's going to search for a different title. It's going to input the different filters that we want, such as for the people, for the location, for the category type of contact that we want. And after that, we want our robot to click on the connect button, to add a note, to type in a message, and then to send this to the person. And we wanted to do it for all of these people that we have, and also for all of the other pages of people that we have. Now, as I always say, if we can, let's create a robot that is as simple as possible. That means that we shouldn't automate every single thing in LinkedIn, meaning we shouldn't click on LinkedIn, go from the homepage, log in, and navigate through all of the different pages. We will perform the filter that we want to do, get the link, and start from here. This will save us some steps in automating all of the different actions that are required to get to this page. That is going to make our robot more efficient and better working. So once we have our link, we can start creating our automation. We're gonna open a Internet Explorer or Microsoft Edge, and we're gonna do our automation on Microsoft Edge. By inputting the link, this is going to automatically open the link. However, there is a problem with this link. As you can see, this link has been encoded. So what we have to do to make it work in Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, we just have to decode this link. This is extremely simple. All we have to do is go to a URL decoder service online, paste our link, and get this link that comes out, which is the decoded version of our link. So let's copy this, go back to our automation, paste it, maximize the screen, and test out our automation and see if it's working so far. If it's opening Microsoft Edge and going to the page that it's supposed to be going. It seems to be working. It has opened the page and has opened it with all of the different filters that we need. Now let's pass on to the next step. Let's try to click on this button, add a note, add some text, and then click on the send button. As always, there is different ways that we can do this. We can do this by dragging and dropping different things. We can automate our keyboard. We can do it in all kinds of different ways, but I like to start with the simplest way first. The simplest way would be to use the recorder. So let's click on the recorder and see what we can get done with this recorder. The recorder is a tool that's going to help you create a basic skeleton for your process and also give you some pretty good selectors. And I'll show you in a second what I mean. So let's click on the record and record the different actions that we need. So we're going to get the innermost element out of this. So we're going to click on this connect. After that, we're going to click on the add note. We're going to right click into the text area and we're going to add text with IME. After adding the text that we want to add, we're going to click on add text. This is going to add the text. And finally, we're going to click on the send button. So let's click on this send button right here. So this is going to send our message. And also right here in the record actions, we can see that we have recorded all of the different actions that we need for our automation. Now let's do one more thing. So let's click on one more button and let's exit out of this. And let's click on one more button and exit out of this. We are doing this because we are looking for differences in these buttons so that we can create an automation that's going to click on all of the different connect buttons, not just the first one. You will know what I'm talking about just a little bit later in this video. All of this is extremely simple. We're not creating any code, writing any code. We're just using a new tool. If this is all new to you, don't worry. This is just feeling you're feeling a little bit overwhelmed because the tool is new. However, it is a very simple tool, but yet very powerful. All right, now let's get rid of everything that we don't need. So this was the code that has been generated for us automatically by the recorder. I got rid of the comments and also of the first action that served to launch a new Microsoft Edge. So we're launching Microsoft Edge, and if we go right here in the right UI elements, we can see everything that has been created for us. Now, while our memory is still fresh, we should click and rename on these different elements so that we don't get confused as we're walking in. So I'm gonna rename this. I have renamed all of the elements that I need. Now these two last spans are the connect button, just a different connect button. I don't need this. I will need those for something else. All right, now we could try our automation and see if it's working. I am going to add a couple of weights so that it looks a little bit more human, this automation, and so that I also don't run in the risk of blocking the page or going too fast for the page to load to execute the different actions. So I'm gonna add a couple of weights between the different actions just so to make my automation a little bit more human and a little bit less like a robot. I have added a wait of 2 seconds between every single action. Let's run our automation and see what happens so far. It is successfully launching LinkedIn on the right page. Now the next thing that it should do, it should click on the connect button. It has clicked on the connect button, and now it should also add text, and perfect. Our automation should stop right here. It's working perfectly fine. That's great. And the last part should send the message. All right, now let's stop this for a second and let's change it a little bit up. So right now we're just clicking on one button. We want to click on all of the different buttons. So how do we do that? Well, it's very simple. We have to add in a loop. This is what we always do when we have a repetitive action to do. We're gonna drag in and drop this loop right underneath our launch new Microsoft Edge. We're gonna start the loop at 0 and add the loop at 10 and increment it by 1. This means that our loop is gonna start at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's gonna go until 10, and then it is going to stop and finish this automation. We're gonna move all of our steps inside of this loop. Once all of the steps are moved inside, we have to do one more thing. What we're doing right now is we're gonna be clicking on just one connect button. We wanna click on the different connect buttons. Let's see how we can do that really quickly. So remember, we took this additional elements of the connect button. Why do we do that? We did that so that we can analyze them and take a little bit a look at them. So I'm gonna copy this element and I'm gonna go into my original connect button. I'm going to add a new element and just paste in what I have. Now, right now, I'm going to look for the differences between these two elements. And here I've spotted the difference already from 2 to 3. So if we make this number dynamic, or if we make it increase by itself, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, our automation is gonna click on button connect 2, button connect 3, button connect 4, and so on, button connect 5, and so on. Extremely simple. So now that we know where our magic button or magic selector is, we're gonna go inside and we're gonna change it. So it is the second tool. So right here, we're gonna change this and we're gonna add our loop index. So this is going to be a dynamic number that is generated automatically with our loop that we have created. Amazing, right? We are done. We're pretty much done. So all we have to do right now is test our automation and see if it's working. Let's add one final thing, and that would be to close the web browser. So let's close the web browser with this. So once our automation is done, it's going to close the web browser. We're gonna move it outside of our loop. We're gonna remove this. All right, we are ready to try out our automation. And just remember, it took us not even a full 10 minutes to build this automation. And this automation can help us save countless hours of time and allow us to do things that otherwise we would not be able to do. So, all right, so we can see a first error that is happening. So it has clicked on the first button, which was a following button. Now this has caused our process to go into crash. So the easiest and quickest way to solve this, we're gonna go into each one of these actions and we're gonna click on error and we're just gonna continue the flow. Why are we doing such a lousy error handling? Well, because we don't expect anything else to happen on this page. So either we're gonna have connect, pending, or following. So whatever, if it's not connecting, if it's not connect, then we're gonna tell our automation, just go to the next step, and so on. So if you don't find a connect or if you don't find that action, just go on to the next button. So for the first one, following, well, you're just gonna skip it and go to the next one. If this one is not connect, you're just gonna skip it and go to the next one, and so on. So we're just going to do this really quickly on error and continue flow run for each one of our actions. Now, also for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to change this to 4. Why? Because in our process here, we are starting, I think, from number 4 or number 5. So we're going to start from here and go all the way until the end of the page. If this process works, well, fingers crossed that it is going to work. Let's add one final on error here. And this should do it. In just less than 12 steps, we have created this process. Again, fingers crossed that it is going to work. And just in a little bit, I'm also going to show you a couple of more tips and tricks on how we can make this process even more better. All right, so far so good. We are sending an invite to Xin. We've managed to send in the text and we managed to send them the invite. That is awesome. So we sent our first invite. It took us literally no time because a robot is doing it for us. And here is a invite for Ankita. It's a pleasure to meet you. And here we go. We send another invite. And here is another one. So this automation is working. It's gonna do it for 10 times. Now let's pause right here and stop. So there's one thing that is missing in our automation. Do you know what it is? I think you can tell. What is missing is that we're gonna come to the end of this page and then what? How are we going to change from this page onto the next page? Are we gonna click next and then repeat the cycle? Well, there is even a faster way to do it. And it all goes with this link that we're gonna look at right here. So this link, once we click on one of these pages, all the way in the end of the link, we get this, page 3. So if we add this to our link, we can make it go from one page to the other. So let me show you what I mean. So if I change this page number, if I change it to, for example, 5, now we are going to go automatically to page number 5. Let's try it out and see if it works. So here we are at page 5, a whole set of new connections that we haven't sent messages to. All right, let's pause this automation and finalize our process. What do I mean by finalized? We need a way of incrementing this page number from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that once we finish executing all of the 10 invites that we have in here, we're not going to close the browser just yet, but we're going to change this page number from 5 to 6 to 7 or something else. Just very quickly, you will do that with the loop. However, I'm going to let you do this so that you figure it out yourself. It is extremely simple. If you need some help, I'm here to help. Ask some comments down below and it will be given to you. Also, remember that I have left the code for this video on the Process Lens webpage, where you find all of the code for this automation and many others. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.